inside 50 just drifted away. Sometimes it's not how fast you are, it's how smart you are.
Front square, James Gowans, he'll try and wobble it through, it bounces through.
James Gowan, 245 games and 270 goals for Central Districts, a member of the Premiership team for Central Districts from 2000 to 2010 in 9 of those years, 5 matches for South Australia, best and fairest for Central's and Norm Russell medal in 2003, Jack Odie medal in the year 2000, Bob Quinn medal in the year 2002, a player life member of Central Districts inducted in 2009, and a player life member of the South Australian National Football League. Please welcome the induction, James Gowan.
G'day, James.
G'day, Soders. How are you, mate?
Good, mate. You?
Yeah, going well. Actually, now, I'm glad we're actually up here early.
It's good, isn't it?
The way those Heinekens were going down. Actually, did a roast with Soders a couple of years ago.
It was for both of you boys. The footy club put it on. Just tell everyone how it finished up.
Footy club made all the money out of it. We didn't get a dollar. But I couldn't talk by the time I got up there. I was drinking beers with Dad at the OG early in the day. And I'm glad I'm up early anyway, so...
That's why we did that. You know that.
Yeah, I know.
It had nothing to do with the coin toss. We saw your performance at the Central Roast and you had to go before Chris.
It's embarrassing.
Well done, mate. Congratulations.
Thanks, mate.
You feeling good?
I'm a bit embarrassed, actually.
Why is that?
When you look down the list and you see all the names in the Hall of Fame, it's it's humbling and obviously honoured, and you don't think you deserve to be in there. But, it's a great honour.
Well, like Chad before, I think you sit here very comfortably, and if we get to the other bloke a little bit later, he might sit there too. Let's just have a look at the screen. Now, this sort of nonsense has been going on with you two for what? What age did all this sort of stuff start?
Well, I think it started at the start. Chris is 8 minutes older.
Yep.
He's a centimetre taller. He's about 2 kilos heavier. He's actually referred to as the womb hog because I got denied, the oxygen and that. But we still do it now, actually, Soders. We've actually done some work at Soders' house, and we're dickheads, actually.
I've got to talk to you about that leak in the roof because it's getting worse.
Yeah, right.
Mate, the rivalry is astounding. Mongrel.
Yeah.
Tell us how it all started, because I believe, is it true that he actually wasn't even at your birth?
Well, Dad had a practice game for West Footscray back in those days. I think he was 48 and still had to be at the practice game. But, Chris was born at 2 o'clock. I was born at 2:08.
So Mungrel,
Saturday afternoon, and Mungrel
dropped your mum off at hospital.
Apparently at half time, someone yelled out because there's no mobile phones. Mungrel, you had twins. He went, well done, played the second half.
Your mum's had a hard time too, because I know some of these stories we've heard before, but she's had to put up with a blood nose or a broken nose, in fact, too at home, hasn't she, from you guys?
Yeah, well, Chris was demonstrating how he threw his first elbow at a ruckman at Ocean Grove 1 year, and as he gave it, Mum was walking past with the iron and his shirt and copped the full brunt of it. Chris knocked her clean out as she went down. Now, we grew up in Sunshine as well. We didn't have much money, so the carpet was not great.
Mm.
But Dad was in his jocks having a few salted peanuts, and we'd suck the salt off in the chair. And I was going off at Chris, "You just knocked Mum out." And Dad ran out, "What's the matter?" And I said, "Chris has just knocked Mum out." Mum's prostrate, got blood pissing out of her nose. Dad said, "Don't let her bleed on the carpet." So Chris and I then picked her up, arms and legs, put her in the bath until she come to. Come to the 21st, didn't she?
Look at him telling you to stop it now. Go and thank some people.
Right. I had a speech written, and I'm not going to read it because it's not great. So I got through my wedding without one, so I reckon I'll get through here. But firstly, honestly, like to thank the SNFL. It's a great competition here. You only realise how good it is once you're not from here. The supporters at Central Districts are so passionate. They've actually made Chris and my lives, you know. We get work out of them. They buy us beers all the time. So you only realise how great a competition is until you're not from here. But I'd like to thank my family. It's the first time all six of us have been here since the weddings or whatever. Mum doesn't fly, so thanks for coming, Mum. She's crook again. Stacey didn't get a mention in our book. We had the club historian wrote a book and forgot we had a sister. So we've got one, Stace. She's come. Thanks for coming. And Mark was an umpire fife, and that's probably why we hated you guys so much, because Mark used to just give us the shits. But no, he was our first time manager for football. He used to go and knock on the club's doors, try and get us a game, and it didn't work. We didn't make it. So anyway, we come to Adelaide, but Mark's our biggest supporter and always has been. I want to thank Christy that night at the Havelock in 2002. It was fantastic, wasn't it? And then I finally married you 10 years later. Out on this oval, actually, we got married. But we've got a beautiful daughter now, and you know, everyone asks me if you're going to stay in Adelaide or, you know, we ever go home. And I used to say, because I wanted to get more money every year, yeah, I'm definitely going to head home next year. But, you know, this is my life now. I've loved Adelaide forever. Finally, I'd like to thank the Wedge, Chris Grant, who actually made it here tonight. He's the CEO, long-time CEO of Central Districts. He doesn't usually come to these shows. So I don't know why. Probably because he didn't fit into his suit. So Chris and I are up for $250 at the end of the night because we had to buy a new one. But Wedge, the day you rang, Mum picked the phone up. We'd just been given St Kilda the arse. And Mum said, James, it's Chris Grant from the Bulldogs. I thought it was Chris Grant. We're lifelong Footscray fans. Just won the Brownlow. Well, he didn't win it, but he should have. I thought, shit, Footscray want me. My dreams have come true. Anyway, we spoke to it. Turned out it was Chris Grant with a K from the Central Districts Bulldogs. We're still pretty happy, anyone that wanted us. So when we finally met him, he actually come over. Sunshine was a tough place where we grew up. We actually went to school with, does everyone know the first series of Underbelly? All the criminals and that. We actually went to school with all those guys. We're still here. They're all dead. But I remember when Granny drove into Sunshine to sign us up, Dougie Thomas had been on the phone to me brother. We didn't even know about it. But Doug, I'll have a beer with you later. And Granny was too scared to get out of the car, weren't you? To walk to the door. But anyway, I'm glad he came over and signed us up because it's made our life. And really proud and humbled to be in here. And we're having a sportsman's night at Sedan with Chris Dittmar in a couple of weeks. If you want to hear some funny stories, we'll get him out then.
James Gowans, congratulations. Well done, mate.